this is beginner's yoga on the mat. We're not going to get off of the mat. We're going to go over some key foundational movements. We're going to take it really slow. And other than down dog, we're going to be on the mat, either seated or on our bellies or on our back the entire time. So let's start by setting intention and doing a little breathing. Come to any comfortable seated position. Draw the spine up nice and long. Place the hands anywhere you're comfortable having them. They can be on the knees with the palms up or down. They can be stacked in your lap, or they can be at heart center. Find any position that's comfortable for you, and if you're comfortable doing so, go ahead and close your eyes. Now just focus on your breath, setting your intention for class. You don't have to do anything to the breath just yet, just notice it. Pay attention to the body. And making a deal with yourself now that you're going to be gentle with yourself, listen to your body, and then you're not going to judge what your body is comfortable with doing and uncomfortable with doing. We're going to accept it and honor it. Now take a nice deep inhale and exhale. Good. You can open your eyes if you'd like. We're going to begin by reaching up toward the ceiling. I want you to leave the tailbone rooted firmly to the ground while lifting and lengthening the upper body. Inhale, reach all the way up. And exhale, lower. Inhale, reach, lift and lengthen, keep the tailbone grounded. And exhale, lower. And again, inhale and lift. And exhale, lower. Good. Then bring the hands to rest. Drop the chin to the chest. Slowly and gently take the head all the way around, circle it and stretch. Breathe. And when the chin reaches the chest again, reverse. Take the head the other direction. And when the chin reaches the chest again, bring it back up to center. Nice deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Good. Let's roll the shoulders back. And forward. And shrug up and down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. And exhale. Good. I'm going to take the left arm, lift it up, and reach it over to the opposite knee. Take the other hand, place it behind the back. You're gently twisting to the right. Deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Gently unwind top to bottom. Back to center. This time, taking the right arm up and over to the opposite knee. Other hand goes behind the back. Inhale and exhale. And gently unwind, bringing it back to center. Good. Moving into some body rolls now. Inhale, sweep it down. Exhale, back. Inhale down, exhale back. Inhale down, exhale back. Last one, inhale down, exhale back. And now reverse it, inhale down, exhale back. Inhale down, exhale back. Inhale down, exhale back, last Let's go ahead and bring the soles of our feet together into what's known as cobbler pose or bound angle pose. The soles of the feet are touching, and we're letting the knees fall apart away from one another. Now your knees may be higher up, and that's okay. And if you like, and you have a block or some other prop for support, like pillows, you can stick those underneath the legs. That helps or feels more comfortable. Again, honor your body. Don't try to shove your legs open further than they're willing to go. But if you have more open hips, you can go ahead and allow them to open up to the side. Concentrate here on the height, lifting and lengthening. Good. And now go ahead and begin to push your chin forward as though you're trying to stick it out past your feet. Lift and lengthen, and now press forward without allowing the tailbone to rock up off of the mat. Breathe. One more. Good. And gently come back to a straight seated position. If a slow butterfly motion feels good to you, you can try that here.
Stack the elbows underneath the
shoulders. Feet are flat, with the soles of the feet facing up toward the ceiling. Fingertips still spread nice and wide. And the feet are about a hip width apart. Go ahead and bring your forehead onto the mat for going into Sphinx pose. Inhale, lift the head and the chest. Draw the shoulder blades back. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, lift.
Tailbones are grounded directly to your mat.
to draw the spine up nice and straight. Lift the upper body up and lengthen. Legs are extended out in front of us. Feet are flexed. Hands out to the side. Staff pose. Let's go ahead. Look straight ahead. Deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Good. Prepping for a seated forward fold. We're going to bring the arms all the way up. And then reach forward as though we're trying to grab onto the feet. Don't grab onto the mat. Just reach forward as though you're trying to. And focus on trying to keep that spine straight as you reach. Feel that engagement all along the leg here, the calf, the quads, the hamstrings. Breathe. Good. Now, if you feel comfortable lowering into a seated forward fold, you may. We're going to get a little bit lower with each breath. We're going to inhale first. With each exhale, a little bit lower if you can. Listen to your body. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good. I want you to continue to breathe here. Notice that you can reach forward for the toes, for the soles of the feet, for the ankles, the shins, for the calves, any area here that is comfortable for you, or remain uplifted and actively reaching forward. Use your exhales to bring you deeper into the stretch. Inhale, create space in the body. Exhale, sink deeper into the stretch. Deep breath. Breath. Gently come up to seated. Reach those hands up toward the ceiling. And exhale out to the side. Good. If you'd like to shake it out here, you can. And we're going to go into a seated spinal twist. Go ahead and bend your left leg. This is the first step. You can stay right here if you'd like. Or if you'd like a little bit more intensity, go ahead and cross that foot over. You may stay right here, or you can pull that foot in closer to your hip. Now take the right arm, wrap it around that leg. Take the left arm and place it behind your back, allowing yourself to twist to the left. Inhale and exhale. For a deeper stretch in the neck, take the head over the back shoulder. One more breath. Gently unwind top to bottom. Bring the head to center first. And then unwind the head, neck, shoulders, chest, waist, and hips. Go ahead and if this leg is crossed, uncross it, straighten it, shake it out if you want to, and then bend up your right leg. You may leave it here, or you may cross it over. You can stay right here, pull it in closer to you. And this time you're taking the left arm, wrap it around that leg. Take the right arm behind the back, twisting yourself. Deep breath. For a deeper stretch in the neck, we're looking over that back shoulder. We're moving with our next breath, and we're going to unwind top to bottom. So go ahead and bring the head to center first, and then gently unwind head, neck, shoulders, chest, waist, and hips. Uncross the leg if it's crossed, straighten it out, and shake it up. to vent up toward the ceiling. You can stay right here, or you can come into a half wind or full wind pose. So half wind is lifting one leg up, wrapping the arms around it, pulling it in toward you. Don't forget to do both legs, or a full wind is bringing both legs up at the same time and wrapping both arms around the legs. And from here, you can rock side to side if that feels good, or you can just stay perfectly still. If this is uncomfortable, go ahead and leave both feet flat on the mat. Let's go ahead and come to stillness. Release the soles of the feet back down to the mat. The feet are about a hip width apart. Knees are facing up toward the ceiling. And from here, go ahead and walk the feet out to the edges of the mat. They're out as far as you can get them without the feet being on the floor. Go ahead and take the hands, either place them on the belly, stack them above the head, or extend the arms all the way out with the fingertips reaching away from you. Gaze up toward the ceiling. Inhale here. On the exhale, allow both knees to release down to the right side of the body. Both feet peel up off of the mat. Leave the back on the mat. Inhale, soles of the feet back to the mat. Knees up toward the ceiling. Exhale, release both knees to the left, peeling the soles of the feet up off of the mat. Inhale, soles of the feet back to the mat, knees up toward the ceiling. Start windshield wiper movement. Exhale to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right.
Again, lift the shoulders and the head flat down on the mat. And neck is long here, but we're crunching in. Again, same rules apply on this side. You can straighten the leg, whatever feels good. You can rotate or point flex. This is also a place where you may want to use a strap. And if you do not have a yoga strap, you can try a towel or a scarf or a belt. That leg is straight, go ahead and bend it. Release the foot to the mat, gently. Uncross the left leg. Coming back into wind pose, if that's a comfortable position for you. Again, you can stay perfectly still or rock side to side. May remain in wind pose, or if you'd like, you can move into happy baby now. So from wind, take the hands, reach down for either the toes, the soles of the feet, the ankles, or the shins. Find the part of your leg that you're going to hold onto, and from here, you can extend the legs all out. You can open them and keep them bent, or you can bend them all the way. You can alternate between these. Let's gently come to stillness. Bring the legs back into wind pose before releasing the feet to the mat. Extend the legs out all the way. So we're laying flat on the mat. Moving into our shavasana, corpse pose. Then bring your gaze up toward the ceiling. If you're comfortable doing so, go ahead and close your eyes. And from here, just rest, relax, release every muscle in your body. Allow the mat to support all of your weight. Sink deeply into the mat. The video will keep playing for a few minutes, but you may stay in Shavasana for as long as you like. Namaste.